Imagine if we had permanent signs glued to our backs, listing the illnesses we had for the world to see. Think of the discrimination you might face in your day-to-day lives. It may sound absurd, but this is the reality for those living with psoriasis, a scaly skin disease with devastating mental and physical consequences. Like the image depicted, psoriasis is like a cascade of falling dominoes. From the toppling of that first domino, or the first appearance of patches of itchy, scaly skin, a chain reaction of associated complications ensues. Poor mental health is so prevalent in those with psoriasis that they are 20% more likely to commit suicide than the average person. Psoriasis is also associated with a range of diseases, including arthritis, diabetes, and cardiovascular disease, which altogether can decrease an average life expectancy by up to 10 years. Today, over 125 million people live with the mounting burden of psoriasis. In order to reduce this burden, we need to understand what is the trigger responsible for toppling that initial domino. Recent research says inflammation is to blame. Chronic inflammation in the case of psoriasis, which causes our cells to lose normal function. In this case, our skin cells become thick, red, and scaly. What's more, topical drugs, the current standard of treatment for psoriasis, only work to alleviate the symptoms of inflammation rather than treat them at their origin. For this reason, we need to develop more effective treatment options that directly target the inflammation. In my thesis, I focus on validating one potential inflammatory target, an enzyme known as Granzyme K. Granzyme K has been shown to stimulate surplus inflammation in the skin. However, its role in psoriasis is unknown. And so after validating that Granzyme K levels were elevated in human psoriasis tissue, I set out to understand whether this coincided with disease development. To do this, I used an animal model of the disease, comparing regular or wild-type mice to mice unable to produce Granzyme K. And what I found is that in the mice unable to produce Granzyme K, they decreased psoriasis severity. That is, they had thinner skin that was less red and less scaly. They also had a decreased number of inflammatory mediators commonly elevated in psoriasis. And so from this, I was able to conclude that Granzyme K may play a role in disease development. In terms of my next steps, I'm currently in the process of investigating whether Granzyme K can promote psoriasis development in human cell models of the disease, just as it did in the animal models, with the eventual hope that this research will provide the necessary evidence to develop drugs targeting Granzyme K for the treatment of psoriasis and to stop these dominoes from falling. Thank you.